A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 11th Jan, on the front page you have Supreme Court tells government to review orders curbing basic rights in Jammu and Kashmir. So now Supreme Court has started hearing the case of Jammu and Kashmir, restriction on basic rights and free movement in Jammu and Kashmir, and has ordered the government to review forthwith any existing orders that restrict this. So it has asked for publication of all orders on restrictions and review of net suspension, that is internet suspension. So Supreme Court has given directions to government on this now. And here you have steel mesh to replace fences on the borders. So the rickety barbed wires along Pakistan and Bangladesh borders are now going to be replaced with mesh fence made of steel and coated with anti-rust paint. So India has 4,096.7 km long border with Bangladesh and 3,323 km long border with Pakistan. And the cost will of around 1 km of such a fence will be approximately 1.99 crore rupees. So this is the amount which will be spent now. The Border Security Force BSF is deployed along Pakistan and Bangladesh border. So it has been tasked with ensuring that the fence is installed in a time-bound manner. A pilot has also been initiated at a cost of 14.3 crore in Assam Silchar district. Then this is IIP reverses slump, grows by 1.8% in November. So now Index of Industrial Production has recorded a growth of 1.8% in November 2019. Otherwise it was in negative. So now a growth has been witnessed. So manufacturing sector has improved. In November 2018 the growth was 0.2%. NSO, National Statistical Office, it provides the data, and it said the growth in manufacturing sector for the month was 2.7% as against contraction of 0.7% in the same month last year. Then this is Supreme Court stays NCLAT order reinstating Cyrus Mistry. So now Supreme Court has given its order against the NCLAT ruling. So National Company Law Tribunal, appeals go to National Company Law Appellate Tribunal, NCLAT, and then from there appeals can go to Supreme Court. NCLAT had asked that Cyrus Mistry should be reinstated as its chairman, Tata Sons chairman, but Tata head, the chairman emeritus Ratan Tata, he had said that this cannot be acceptable because he was the chairman and he was removed, he's the minority stakeholder in Tata Sons, and he was removed by the board. So this is the whole case. Now Supreme Court will hear this matter, and till that time it has stayed NCLAT order. Means he need not be reinstated, Cyrus Mistry, right now. Then this is judges bail condition, attend CAA session. So all the 12 accused of violence during the recent anti-CAA protest in Simapuri were granted bail by a city judge, but they have been asked to appear at a local police station where police officers could remove their doubts about the contentious law. So these 12 violence accused were told to visit the police station on Jan 19. So this was a bail condition as such. And now Union Home Ministry notifies Citizenship Amendment Act provisions. So Citizenship Amendment Act rules are yet to be notified, but now a notification has come on the provisions of the act which came into force on Jan 10. So it was passed by both the Houses of Parliament on December 11, 2019. And now you can see the president also gave his assent on December 12. And now rules yet to be notified, but what has been seen is the provisions have been published. Now notification on their provisions has come. So act came into force on Jan 10 itself. On page 8 you have Supreme Court rejects appeal against demolition of resorts. So, Supreme Court has upheld 2013 Kerala High Court ban on construction and has dismissed appeals by Capico Kerala Resorts Private Limited against Kerala High Court decision banning the construction of resorts and removal of structures on backwater islands on Vembanad Lake in Alappuzha district of Kerala. So, Supreme Court has also upheld Kerala High Court order and wants demolition of resorts on backwaters. Then below you have all set for waterbird census in AP. So annual bird census will commence in Koringa Wildlife Sanctuary in Andhra Pradesh and the surrounding wetlands in Godavari mangrove cover on the east coast of India. So these migratory and resident birds will be documented. On page 9 you have ED attaches assets of Kochar couple. So this is Enforcement Directorate which looks into money laundering case. So this is regarding Chanda Kochar, who is former CEO and MD of ICICI Bank. So she and her husband Deepak Kochar and his companies as such, they are accused in this case in which it is said that ICICI Bank gave loans in collusion. So in this case, now there is a money laundering case against them. So Enforcement Directorate has attached the assets worth 78 crores. Like this is a flat, you can see cash and other assets. So they have been seized. And this is MOD approves rules of business for DMA. So this is Ministry of Defense which has approved the rules of business for the newly created Department of Military Affairs, which will be headed by the CDS, Chief of Defense Staff. So presently the Chief of Defense Staff is General Bipin Rawat. So its rules of business have been finalized now. This will be a department and a Ministry of Defense headed by General Bipin Rawat. So it will have two joint secretaries, 13 deputy secretaries, under secretaries and section officers, you can see. And its mandate, it will look into defense imports and procurements as such. So that is it. So these are under the Department of Defense. So this is Defense Secretary which heads them. DMA's mandate includes promoting jointness in procurement, training and staffing of services, facilitating restructuring of mission commands, optimal utilization of resources as such. So establishing joint data commands, promoting use of indigenous equipments. So this will be what Department of Military Affairs would look into. Department of Defense would look into defense imports and procurements. So this is the fifth department under Ministry of Defense. It already has four. You can see Department of Defense, Defense Production, Defense Research and Development, Defense Department of Ex-Servicemen Welfare. On editorial page, the first editorial is Eloquent Reticent. So eloquently reticent. So this talks about the Supreme Court ruling on Jammu and Kashmir curves. So this indefinite internet bans. Ruling has been given against it, but Supreme Court fails to decide on the validity of JNK curves. So it has spoken on whether these bans should whether further continue or not, but it should stop. But then whether they can the curves can be brought in, that has not been looked into. That is there. And the second editorial is a health emergency. So this is regarding polio. It says polio remains a concern despite concerted efforts across the world. So polio which is a viral infection, so viral disease. So World Health Organization has announced on January 7 that polio will continue to remain a public health emergency of international concern for 3 months. So this is there. So emergency as such has been declared now. This was a recommendation of the emergency committee under international health regulations too. So it has been done. And India has a huge burden of polio cases too. So polio virus type 1 is the one which generally gets exported from Pakistan to Iran and Afghanistan too. So India, Pakistan, Afghanistan are where the major burden of polio disease lies, apart from Nigeria. So it has actually succeeded in eradicating polio this year. So once it is free, then entire African region will become free of wild polio virus. Then the lead article is human rights are not solely an internal matter. So this it says with the evolution of international law in the last 100 years, the concept of unrestricted sovereignty has weakened. So human rights is not an internal matter that other countries should not speak on it. But if there are human rights violations, so that's what it is talking of, that international laws have also evolved. So sovereignty cannot be unrestricted. If you are sovereign and you can do anything internally in the country. Then this is a taking a holistic approach to dengue. So this talks of dengue. So it says apart from vaccination, this has to involve efficient vector control and proper case management. So the dengue is a vector-borne disease. It is the mosquito through which the disease is spread. So talking about vector control too. So vaccination efforts are being made for dengue, but here you can see it says there is a need for mosquito control. Then on Saturdays on the op-ed page you have ground zero coverage. So today it is regarding JNU, Jawaharlal Nehru University. So the protests actually began here over fee hike, and then campus rivalry actually further intensified, and politically targeted violence was conducted here. The clash between leftist student organizations and RSS affiliated Akhil Bharatiya Vidyarthi Parishad have taken place, and this is a complete ground zero report on the issue. On page 12 you have section 144, not a tool to suppress opinion, Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court has said that order of restrictions under section 144 of CRPC could not be used to suppress legitimate expression, opinion and grievances in a democracy. So the restrictions which have been imposed in Jammu and Kashmir are being questioned by Supreme Court now. And this is government stand on total net blockage rejected. So goal behind curb, it says, should be legitimate, the Supreme Court. So Supreme Court has denied this blanket suspension of internet in Kashmir. That's what it says. State cannot deny free speech on net as such. On page 13, you have Assam specific CA rules sought. So there are protests in Assam against Citizenship Amendment Act, and Assam Chief Minister has asked for Assam specific CA rules. Means he wants that CA has December 31, 2014 cut off for person from minority community from Pakistan, Afghanistan, Bangladesh to get Indian citizenship, but Assam wants pre-2014 presence to be proved to. Means it is not happy with the cutoff date, because under NRC the cutoff date was of 1971. Then below you have Supreme Court asks Center to reply on UN officials' plea on Rohingya. So Supreme Court has asked the Center on this application by UN Special Rapporteur to intervene in a batch of petitions filed by Rohingya community against the Government of India's move to conduct their mass deportation from India. So the UN Special Rapporteur has spoken on this. These are contemporary forms of racism, racial discrimination, xenophobia and related intolerance. So here you can see the Supreme Court bench took note of this plea made by the US Special Rapporteur, and he'll assist the court on India's human rights obligations to racial equality and non-discrimination in the light of international conventions signed and ratified by India. And it has said the move by Union Home Ministry would be incompatible with India's human rights obligations. Then below you have new facility to tackle cyber crimes. So Union Home Ministry, Home Minister Amit Shah has inaugurated the Indian Cyber Crime Coordination Center, which is called I4C. So it means there are 4C, Cyber Crime Coordination Center. So it's a 7-pronged system which includes cyber crime, reporting portal, analysis of threat, capacity building, research and innovation, creating an ecosystem for cybercrime management, and joint cybercrime investigation platform for law enforcement agencies. So now this has been built at an estimated cost of 415.86 crore rupees. On international page you have Iranian missile downed airliner Trudeau. So this is Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau, who has said that the Ukrainian airline which came down was brought down by an Iranian missile. So this is the claim which he makes. He says this may have been unintentional, but Canadians have questions, because you should remember that in this airline disaster, actually all 176 on board were killed, and there were mainly Iranians and Canadians. Then this is US rejects Iraq request to discuss troop withdrawal. So we had seen after the Iranian military general being assassinated in Iraq, the Iraqi parliament passed a resolution asking the Iraqi government to have US move out. So US said that we are ready to have conversation, but will not pull out. So it has rejected Iraq's request for or to even discuss troop withdrawal. And now US sanctions are again there. It targets 8 top Iran officials, metal industry in Iraq. So it will, these sanctions will continue, it is said, until regime stops funding global terrorism. And this is regarding fires blazing in Australia. Strong winds in Australia have merged two enormous fires into a mega blaze spanning over 4 times the size of Greater London. There are tens of thousands who are rallying to again demand action on climate change. These hot dry winds that again are a real challenge in Australia, causing these huge blazes. 6 lakh hectares is on blaze. On business page, you have Infosys CEO Salil Parekh gets clean chit. So there was this whistleblower plea against Infosys CEO, but then there is no evidence of financial impropriety or executive misconduct is what the Infosys audit committee report says, and he has been given a clean chit. And then you have broadcasters protest new tariff regime. So, the latest tariff order on cable TV pricing from TRAI, it is said, will trigger a massive disruption for the country's broadcasting industry and lead to job losses as well as closure of small niche channels. So, this is what Indian Broadcasting Federation has said, raising questions on TRAI. It has unveiled a 33% cap on discounts that can be offered to cable subscribers opting for a channel bouquet and a price cap of Rs. 12 per channel to be included in the bouquet. So this is down from 19 rupees per channel in the current regime, which is there. It has asked for reduction in prices, which is being protested. And then here you have RBI chalks out financial inclusion strategy for 2024. So RBI aims at universal mobile access to financial services, and it has chalked out its ambitious strategy for financial inclusion, in which it aims to strengthen the ecosystem for various modes of digital financial services in all tier 2 to tier 4 centers. The necessary infrastructure would be put in place towards a cashless society by 2022. And then the entire time frame is till 2024. And this is worst auto sales decline in 2 decades. So prior to 2019, it is said annual sales fell only twice in 22 years, that is in 2007 and 2008. But now we have seen worst auto sale declines. Here you can see even gems and jewelry exports have declined. Engineering exports are also at the same pace as last year. And India faces capacity shortage is also highlighted. Then the last page has sports related news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.